Hello all. Today we have Dr. S.C. Kamath with us, who is holding more than 25 years of academic experience and has a doctorate degree in mechanical engineering. Right? He has got several publications in national as well as international journal. Right? And I think he's loaded with accolades and rewards and recognition over here. And we are highly privileged to have you on board, sir, for your precious time, right? So sir, we have got a set of few questions which we wanted to understand from you, right? Starting with that, you have held very key positions in various institutes as well as throughout your academic career, right? So the very first question which comes into our head is, right, that what has been your philosophy of leadership, or in other words, if I have to say, how would you describe your leadership style, sir?
Yeah, very interesting. At the outset, kindly accept my wishes for conducting this kind of online meeting with you.
Okay, thank you so much, sir.
Basically, okay. Basically, leadership comes by way how you share the responsibility of your colleagues and you guide them properly. Rather saying it as guiding, it is taking along with you everybody. That is the basic leadership quality. I quote it in one single statement, that is leading by front.
True, sir. True. Very true, sir. Right.
Right.
Yeah, very well said, sir. Leading by the front, I think in these few words you have explained the entire whole context of it. Right, sir. Now, coming to my next question, sir. I think there are several key programs and plans which are there in every college, right? So I just want to understand from you that how do you strategize about the plans for the marketing and administration of your institute?
Okay, so far as far as marketing is concerned, our institution is quite an old institution, 25 years of establishment, and has got a good credentials, particularly academic credentials. When I speak credentials, it's only academic credentials, nothing else.
Right, right.
So this institution is accredited at A grade by NAC. And all the engineering programs are accredited by NBA, National Board of Accreditation.
Right.
The two credentials is enough without marketing, doing any marketing kind of strategy. My already management quota admission seats are full.
Great, great. That's good to know, sir.
When people are struggling to get admissions, it is a mouth-to-mouth publication or mouth-to-mouth advertisement by our senior students who are our ambassadors, basically. And when they come out from my institution as a graduate engineers, they divert their friends or their relatives, their neighbors, that this is one of the prestigious college, you please join. This is a marketing strategy which has worked me better than anything else.
Great,
I always keep my alumni satisfied.
That's good to know. That's really good.
Satisfied alumni is my basic marketing strategy, or you can say strength of this institution. Nothing less or nothing more.
Amazing, sir. Amazing. That's really nice, sir. And sir means obviously, as you have mentioned over here, that the alumni is the biggest strength of them. Then obviously these alumni would be holding quite many key positions in various industries and as roles, right? So I just wanted to understand that in order to make your students that noteworthy, how does the curriculum of college ensure the best practice of industries, sir?
Okay, very interesting question you have raised now. Is most debated question and equally very everyone is after this. As far as the curriculum part of this is concerned, we are an affiliated college to Visveshwaraya Technological University, Belagavi.
Okay.
So we have a very limited scope of moderation or modifications or alterations or doing any changes in the curriculum. Normally affiliated colleges are strictly bound by the curriculum that is issued by the university.
Right.
But within that also, there are a good number of electives which address the burning topics or the industrial needs of latest transactions that are happening in the industry.
Mm-hmm.
So such courses are offered in the college as an electives in addition to regular academics.
Right, right. So there is a proper... Yeah, please, sir. Mm.
That is one thing, addressing the curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
But there are certain things which needs to be addressed beyond curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
However, the curriculum may be strong, but certain things which needs to be addressed beyond curriculum.
Mm-hmm.
So for that, we had a training and placement cell, which takes care of pre-placement training particularly.
Amazing.
In the pre-placement training, we prepare them for industry requirements.
Mm-hmm.
And that is where this year my placement rate is 100%.
Oh, congratulations, sir, for that. Yeah.
And placements, even not in any Tom, Dick, Harry company, they're all good companies like Wipro, Infosys.
Mm-hmm.
All branded companies have placed, my students have been placed in very good positions.
Great, sir. Great means you must be really happy about that. And this very much brings to me my next question, sir, that as all the students of yours are coming with the flying colors, right? Where means or how critical your roles and responsibility to the institution and the students are? And I would like to ask you that if you could enumerate your roles and responsibilities, sir.
Okay, very interesting question. Because as a head of the institution, my role is pretty critical. I shall have to lead three parallel teams. Number one, students. Number two, I need to take my colleague staff members, teaching community and the other employees of the institution. Number three, management.
True.
I have to have a balancing act between all the three. I need to behave like a pivotal point which connects three parallelly. Without any compromise on the quality and discipline of the institution. So, when it comes to particularly discipline, we never compromised on whether it is a student or it is a management or it is employees. Discipline is discipline. Everyone has to fall in the requirement of the institution. But when it comes to motivation part, I'm the first to support any students and any faculty members who wish to take up challenges and new avenues.
Great, sir. That's really motivating even for the faculty members as well.
Absolutely.
Sir. Okay, sir, I think, as you said, it's one of the very prestigious universities as well. But if in case I have to say to the outer world or to the other students, right, if you have to mention something very peculiar and very unique about the institute or something about the college which others might not be knowing, what would be those points, sir?
Absolutely. Now, very, very, very interesting and very concerned question you have raised. This institution is run by a great saint. It does not belong to any politician or any businessman. Great saint called His Holiness Sri Durudundeshwara, who lived here 300 years back. And subsequently, the Mutt, Sri Matha is headed by Mahaswamijis, who are holy persons, and they always look for the welfare of the or well-being of the society. Present Swamiji is a 10th Mahaswamiji, Shivalingeshwar Mahaswamiji, who takes care of this institution and who is really the source of inspiration to all of us. Many a times when parents come from Bombay, Pune and other longer distances, when they meet in the meet Swamiji for his seeking his blessings, Swamiji asks them one question: why did you travel so much of long distance and come down here for taking admissions mm-hmm. when there are a good number of institutions at Bombay and Pune itself? Mm-hmm. What the parents respond is, mm-hmm. Swamiji, my son or daughter, whether they learn engineering or do not learning is a secondary part, mm-hmm. but what they learn is culture, and at least they learn how to bow head in front of elders. That is a very, very special feature of this institution. Mm-hmm. Till today, all the students staying in hostels, mm-hmm. they have a self-service system.
Oh, nice, nice.
They prepare their food, they make their services. It's all, everything is self. Mm-hmm. Self-service. There is no support service to students. They have to groom up in the mm-hmm. Sri Mata culture, mm-hmm. or what we call it as the Gurukula system of education.
Mm-hmm. Right, right. Means, in other words, the college is making the students independent and bringing in real sense on their foot.
Right. A true Gurukula college.
Yeah. Right. So, my next question, which would be, right, any insights into how your institute could be, say, much more welcoming to students of, say, different races or economic backgrounds or geographical states and all?
Absolutely, because admissions are through different platforms. Mm-hmm. Number one, Karnataka state entrance examinations, mm-hmm. the Karnataka state students participate, and 45% of the students come from Karnataka state entrance examinations.
Okay.
And 35% of the students come from COMEDCARE, which is conducted by Association of Private Medical and Engineering College Association of Karnataka. Mm-hmm. So mm-hmm. there also, across the country, the students participate irrespective of limit of the state. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We get 35% of the seats through COMEDCARE. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Remaining 25% of the seats are filled by at management level.
Okay.
So you will have all mix of kind of students that take admission into college. Mm-hmm. Socially economically background, socially rich, well, economically rich, mm-hmm. You can say educationally good, bad, all mix is there.
Great. So means a kind of a diverse culture is there in the entire whole institute. Mm-hmm. Okay. Great, sir. So means, as you mentioned, that economical and diversity, then the placements are good and each and everything are there, right? So the next question which pops is, what do you think are the greatest strength for the institute?
My greatest strength, I could say, is the institution, though located in rural area, is run by a philanthropist, Mahaswamiji. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Who always never look for any profit venture. It is a, you can say, no loss, no profit institution.
Okay.
And because of the, it is run by Mahaswamiji, mm-hmm. No question of making money or making business comes here. Only giving good quality education to society, okay. and welfare of the society is the only prime concern. Nothing, rest all things are secondary.
Right, sir. So I'm pretty sure that the students who would be performing, sir, they would be getting scholarships and say awards and accreditation as well.
Absolutely. I can say last year we received more than 2 crores of state government scholarships.
Oh, nice, sir.
Because we get students, very meritorious students, to my college through Karnataka CET and through COMEDCARE also.
Okay.
So they perform well in the academics also.
Great, sir.
State government is also working very well.
No, sir, it's really important and it's really imperative also. And as you mentioned, means it somewhere or the other keeps the students motivated as well to perform well.
Equally, the institution has a policy of giving scholarship at institution level for the students who score good marks in their academics. or even if they are first class and distinction, mm-hmm. the institution level scholarships are also instituted.
Great, great, great. Okay,
apart
sir.
Apart from government scholarships.
Fair enough. Sir, coming to my next question, right? Now, I mean, as you mentioned that there are kind of three teams which you have been, kind of managing. One is management, the other are students, and the third is the faculty members, right? So, how do you tend to establish a healthy relation and environment in your institution?
Very interesting.
Yeah.
We need to be, we have like a head of the family.
Right.
Then, many times I need to scold them also if they do wrong.
Mm-hmm.
But equally, I shall have to take care of their welfare, care them. We need to address their any requirements also, emergency things, help them financially, psychologically, in all aspects.
Right.
Certainly, people accept your leadership with no looking back.
True, sir. True. A true leader can not always be like, could be soft or something. Sometimes he has to be stern and he has to be maintain the discipline in the entire whole program. Right, sir. Very well said. Sir, along with the strength and along with the success, it is always coupled with some of the other challenges as well. Right. So in the very same context, I wanted to ask you that what are some of the biggest challenges you see both for higher education in general and for this particular institution specifically?
One thing. Okay. So two things I will separately address.
Mm-hmm.
The challenges for higher education is our students need to be redirected for learning, not for job. Learning for their profession. Because now most of the university curriculum and other things have become only the job. We are producing job seekers. We need to groom up job providers. To do that, we need to enrich our curriculum. And to enrich our curriculum, students' mindset has to be changed.
Right.
That is the greatest challenge in the higher education.
True, sir. Very true.
Right. Mm-hmm. Equally, when it comes to challenges to institution, my institution being located in a rural area, many times it becomes very difficult to get connected with the country's renowned institution like IITs or NITs or central universities, and getting the so-called expertise as and when immediately required, as the colleges located as metros could do it.
I understand, sir. Right, but thanks to you means you have been really open about the fact that the challenges which are faced by the institution. Right, sir. Coming to my last question, sir, which is like a very open-ended questions, and I kind of, in general, is kind of open to the entire whole youth, that any suggestion which you would like to give the current young generation and the aspiring students?
Certainly, my advice to my budding engineers, not only engineering students, for all higher education students, whether it's a commerce, arts, or literature, or engineering, medicine, love your profession, not the...
Right.
So basically, unless we love our profession, we cannot excel. So learn from what you love, and love your profession so that you will excel in your profession. Otherwise, it's not possible.
Great, sir. Great. I think the messages and the answers which you have given are really inspiring and, sir, very true to the heart and kind of very motivating as well at the very same time. So, I really appreciate your time which you have given to us, sir. I completely understand that you must be having a very busy schedule. But I thanks a lot for your time, sir, once again. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.